welcome in your English class and today's date is 15th 12 20. So in our last class we were doing grammar, and in grammar we were doing the topic present perfect tense. I hope the topic present perfect tense is clear to you by watching the first video of this chapter. And today is our second class with this. In our previous class I have explained you like how you have to do how you have to see what is present perfect tense, what is present perfect tense, and we have done three exercises A, B, C, one by one to make your concept clear. Now today we are going to move to the next exercise, that is exercise D. Before starting exercise D, we should recall the formula which we have derived for present perfect tense. I have said to keep two things in mind. One, has or have plus verb third form. What is third form? That is past participle. Okay, and the second thing which we have derived is where to use has and where to use have. Has we have to use with singular person, that is she, he, it, or any name. We use has, and have we use with plural person, that is I, you, we, they. Okay, this is with singular person and this is with plural person. So this was the revision of the previous video which we have done, where to use has and have, and means what is the formula for present perfect tense and where to use has and have. So now let's begin with the exercise D. Open your book everyone, page number 65. See here, page number 65, this is your book. Page number 65 we are going to do. Okay, now let's begin. D. Frame the sentences in the present perfect tense using the given sets of words. Some words are given there. What are the words here? Let me write first. Frame the sentences into present perfect tense. Now you all remember now what is present perfect tense. Present perfect tense means the action which has already been done in the past but showing its effect in present. Okay, that is present perfect tense. Now what is the exercise? Let's do. First sentence is I school morning. Three words are given there. I school morning. Now I have to make a sentence showing present perfect tense. Now how we will make? See, first subject is what? I. So I will be there. I have already said with I we use which helping verb? Have. So I will write have. I have. Now school morning. No verb is given there. So this is not a perfect sentence. This is not even a sentence. This is only a group of words but not having complete sense. So I school morning. I have, one thing we have done, has or have used. I have used has or have. Now school, now what I will do to the school? I will go to the school, right? Now go will be the verb here. Now go is the verb. Now what is the third form of go? Go, went, gone. I have gone. I have gone to school. When? In morning. So in this way you will frame the sentence. I have gone to school in morning. So this is the present perfect tense of the three words. I school morning. I have made the sentence. I have gone to school in morning. Now let's see the next example. Now our second sentence. Second set of words. What are the given sets of words? We we complete homework. We complete homework. Now these three words are given to us. We complete homework. Now we have to make a present perfect tense sentence. How? First subject I cannot change, so subject will be we only. So let me write here we. Now for we, what we will use as the helping verb? See here, where is we? Here. That means have. We have. Now verb is complete. Complete, third form, completed. We have completed. We have completed homework. But to make a more means easy reading sentence, we have completed whose homework? Our homework. We have completed our homework. So is it clear? We have completed our homework. So in this way we are going to solve the sentences. Okay, rest 3, 4, 5 I will send you on the WhatsApp group so that you can complete it from there. Okay, now let's move to the next exercise, that is exercise E. Before doing that, let me rub this. Now, exercise E, what it is given? Rewrite the following. Rewrite the following sentences correctly. Rewrite the following sentences correctly. That means the sentence will be given here that will be wrong. First we have to see what mistake is there and then we have to correct it. Okay, so let's see the first sentence. What is the first sentence? Ravi have eaten his food. Ravi have eaten his food. Now how we will see? Just see here. Ravi is how many person? Ravi is the doer or the subject here. So we are concerned with the subject. What the subject is doing. Okay. First, Ravi have. Have. Is it correct? No. Why? Ravi is a single person. And for single person, we use has, not have. So have is wrong here. Okay. So first mistake we have seen, Ravi have is wrong. It will be Ravi has. Now, what is the verb here? Now we are concerned with the verb. Past participle form of the verb. That is eaten. What will be the past participle? Eaten. Is it correct? Okay. Ravi has eaten his food. So this is correct. No problem here. So we have corrected the sentence. The mistake was in the helping verb. Okay. Now let's see the next sentence. We has dancing together. First see what is the subject. We is what? Singular or plural? Plural. So we is plural person. Okay. So we has. We use has with plural person. No, this is wrong. We use have with plural person. We have dancing together. Dancing, ing. Ing is where used? It is used in continuous tense. I have explained you now. Going, coming, eating, dancing, singing. Wherever you will add ing with the verb, that will be showing the continuous form. So here verb is also wrong. Dance is the base form. Dance is the base form. We are concerned with the base form. Whatever the sentence is given, I have to see what is the base form of verb. So dancing is but obviously wrong. So what is the base form of dancing? Dance. Okay, now what will be the past participle form of dance? Danced. D. We have danced together. Is it clear? We have danced together. So this is the way how we have to do the sentence. Let's take one more example. I'm rubbing 1 and 2. Third sentence is Asha have went to school. So we have a sentence Asha have went to school. Now let's see first what is the subject here. Subject is Asha. Asha is a single person or a plural person? Single person. So for single person, any name it can be. I have already said here Asha is a name. So for single person we use has. So here have is wrong. So Asha has. Now what is the verb? Went. Went. What will be the base form of verb went? That is go. We have to keep in mind about go. Okay. Now what will be the third form? Go, went. Went is the second form. But I am concerned about the third form. Go, went, gone. Asha has gone to school. Is it clear? So in this way, we are going to first see the problem. What is the problem in the sentence? And then we are going to solve it. Okay, it is very easy. If you will go with the concept, then you can easily do the exercises. No need to worry about it. Now, we have done exercise E. Now, let's move to exercise F. Now, what is exercise F? That is write true or false. So write true or false, I am not going to copy, I am just going to explain you like this. First sentence, the present perfect tense deals about the thing which have taken place in the past and are relevant to the present as well. Yes, I have already explained you that the action has been done in the past, but it is showing its means effect on present. So this sentence is true. Now second, the present perfect tense also applies to the action that are continuing to take place even at present. Continuing to take place? No, because when the action is continuing, then it is continuous tense. But here we are talking about present perfect tense. So this statement is false. Now third one. We use is, am, are as the helping verb in present perfect tense. No, we don't use is, am, are. We use which helping verb? Has or have. Is, am, are we use with present continuous tense. Okay, so this sentence is also false. Now fourth sentence. Has is used with singular third person in present perfect tense. Has is used with singular third person. Yes. What is third person? Don't get confused. I is the first person. First person. Then you is the second person. And he, she, it are the third person. So third singular person we use has. Yes, it is correct. We use has with third person singular. Now, fifth sentence, that is the last sentence. The plural third person employs have as the helping verb in the present perfect sentences. Yes, the plural third person. What is the plural third person? They. Okay. Employees have as the helping verb. Yes, I have already explained that there we use a helping verb have with the plural person. So the fifth sentence is also the plural third person employees have as the helping verb in the present perfect tense. Yes, this sentence is true. So that's all for this chapter, present perfect tense. I think this topic is clear to you, and I think you have understood how you have to solve this exercise. Just to recall you again, I will explain you these two things again. Just see it carefully. Present perfect tense, that means the action which has already been done in the past but showing its effect on present. Now, how you have to derive the formula? Has or have plus verb third form. Now, what is verb third form? That is past participle form of verb. Okay, now has or have, where to use has and where to use have? Has we use with she, he, it, or any name that is for singular person. Okay, and where to use have? We use have, I, you, we, they. That means for the plural person we use have. So this concept of has and have is clear. Now verb third form, this thing you have to learn it thoroughly. In the back of your book also many verbs are given, and it's all the three forms are given, or you can get from any other grammar book the verb and the three forms of verb. So you have to learn it thoroughly so that you can easily solve the grammar chapter. Any chapter that is related with tense, it will be easily means clear to you how you have to do. For that you have to learn the three forms of verb. This is your homework to complete the exercises of this chapter. All the exercises in the previous class we have done ABC, but those students who have not done ABC, you have to complete this also in this exercise, in this video, and DEF today we have discussed, and you have to do it. The remaining exercise I will send you on WhatsApp group so that you can complete it. Okay, thank you students, and have a nice day. Stay at home and stay safe. Bye bye.